Hello everyone, this is Sheldon from Shellrock Art. Welcome to my channel and another adventure of paint pouring. And today we're going to do a room, but we're going to try to arrange the colors so that we're layering transparent and opaques to bring out the jelly beans. Now I'll show you my test piece to help you understand what I mean by jelly beans. Sometimes there's a question behind what they are. So here's a test piece. I will put that under the camera there. And you see how those cells kind of glow in the middle, but also have a nice sharp edge that's opaque on the outside. That's because of the different layerings of the transparent and opaque colors. So I'm going to try to repeat this process, but on this 10 by 10 canvas. That was a 4 by 4 tile. And as we all know, the bigger the canvas, harder to pour. Anyway, so we can get started. I have everything together, I believe. I made a nice fresh batch of cell activator, which is Paynes Gray, Artist Loft, Professional Series. And this cell activator has US floetrol, as opposed to Australian. I never used Australian floetrol, so I can't even speak on it. But I can speak on US floetrol and how I was able to get the cells to work very well for me. So I'm putting down my base coat, which is the Glidden Premium Semi-Gloss Pure White. It will say base one. I add a little bit of water to it to help it flow better. I don't like my base to be too thick. I used to do it straight out the can, but when I learned that when I added my water to it, it kind of flowed better. That's me. And it didn't crack as much. Now, for somebody else, maybe it's a different story. But I can't speak on it again. So, let's start with a base of yellow. So this is not exactly an opaque color, but it's a light transparent color so that some of the glow from the pillow will come through the yellow. But on the concentrated parts of the yellow, some of the glow of the yellow is going to come through the next transparent color, which will be Quinacridone Magenta. Quinacridone, Quinacridone, Quinacridone. I like to say that word for some reason. So Quinacridone Magenta goes on next. And I'm going to lay it on loosely because I also want some multicolored cells too. And I find that when you lay it on loosely like that, that's what happens. So give like a messy grid. And then this is Be Mine from ColourArte. Look at that rich turquoise light color. It's called Be Mine. Now to contrast that, I have some Dioxazine Purple. The Dioxazine Purple is from Liquitex. That Quinacridone Magenta is from the Artist Loft Professional Series as well. Now I don't make a cell activator out of that because it's a transparent color. I will use it only as a cell activator if it's opaque. If you want the cell activator to stand out, not get lost in the colors beneath, especially if those colors are darker. Now to go against the violet, I have this interference violet here, and I added some green sparkle pigment to it as well. This is also from Primary Elements ColourArte. Let me turn this way. Kind of recenter my puddle. This is not centered level, by the way, so it keeps drifting, but if I keep shifting it back and forth, I can keep it in the middle. Now for my opaque color. Now my opaque color, I'm not gonna drizzle because I want it as a guide or as a border under my cell activator. So I will keep that as a puddle in the center, like so. The purpose of that is I will put the cell activator directly on top. They will glide together as I blow it out. And then this will border the black cell activator and border the cells that these multicolors will make. That's my intentions, and hopefully it'll work out. This cell activator is Paynes Gray. Artist Loft Professional Series. It's a heavier body paint, so it'll sink down the same way some of these other paints will, like the Amsterdam and the Golden colors. So it's a very decent paint to work with when you're making a cell activator. And this has a mixture of US floetrol, 2-to-1, and then I mix it with the Paynes Gray to get the proper consistency. I want it to be thin, at least thinner than my other colors. It's already making a halo here, so that's good. So let's blow this puppy out. Sometimes I don't like the way I blow out. So let me get my straw. See, now as I'm trying to explain it, that one didn't work quite as well as I liked it. So we're gonna try again. But you see some of the jelly bean happening here and here. Through there, there's some pieces that's got the colors that I was looking for. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fold this pillow back in. Not waste a lot of paint. Try again, but this time I will lay it down more directly on top of each other. So We'll try again. I give credit where credit is due. This little trick I learned watching Karen from Waterfall Acrylics. So, shout out to Karen right there. Man, that interference gold with the green sparkle was definitely coming out. So I'm gonna do that again. And just a little bit more of the white. Let's go with these colors again. The Tuscan Sun. And that's a Prizm pour color. By the way, the annual inventory sale for ColourArte pigments and other items is on. It's been on from the 22nd, and I'll have to try to remind myself of when it ends. But right now it's on, and you get 25% off of all the items. And you could use my code, but this is a different code, ShellRockArt2125. So, if you wanna go to the ColourArte website to order some Primary Elements pigments or some Prizm pour or other items, and you could do that. That's the purple. Now keep all that center. Go with my old school way of doing things. I'll go with this over top though. All over the place. And then my green. Now this is not a, this is actually folk art, a color shift of green and gold. That's what this is here. But it's opaque. And back to the cell activator of Paynes Gray. And this time I'll put plenty on there. Alright. Center it. Nope. Let's blow it out right now. Collect together. That gave me a few more jelly beans that I liked. And as that collects, I'm definitely going to, I want to collect a little bit more before I start to blow with the straw. And there's some areas in here I want to kind of open up. now there's a lot of jelly beans in there. As it's collecting. So, per usual, I'm going to take part of this and add some swirls to it. I use the fat part of what I broke off. I don't want to use the actual point because the fatter part can actually pull the paint better when you're making swirls. So, just a little tip on that too. Most times, as I said many times in my videos, I do swirls in it, curly cues, whatever you want to call them, when I have like lumped areas like that. I don't necessarily like to mess with my cells and lacing, so just when I see like a few little bumps, odd shapes, I swirl them out. And it's funny because that can be random, which means that the swirls can all be on one side. And not necessarily on the other side. Which gives it an abstract feel to it. But overall, this has turned out really good. I had really good. This is turning out very well. And I'm excited over it. So hopefully you like what you see here. Subscribe to my channel for other videos and experiments. Because in actuality, I'm always trying to reinvent the wheel. That's how this art form tends to play out. But this little spot right here is a straight line. I don't want that. If you use a toothpick, make sure you wipe off the toothpick every time you use it so that you don't reintroduce paint back into your painting. Love the way that paint sank. Now the idea of the cell activator, this is what I was trying to tell you, is that these paints, like the pillow paint and the other colors, are lighter in density, even though the consistency is thicker, but in density of the paint itself, it's lighter than the top layer or the cell activator. So the cell activator is actually, even though it's thin, it's a denser paint, so it's sinking down into the other paint, causing the cells to rise up. Kind of like the way bubbles come up into the top of a soda. So all these cells represent bubbles coming up into the soda. So now that I kind of gave a small explanation of that, let's spin this puppy out. I'm going to center the bloom. So I'll move this over slightly to where this is centered into the spinner, and that way it can still spread out even. Spin out slow. been slow for a very specific reason. I don't like my cells to get all crazy shaped. And even my swirls, I try to not jerk it. And so when you jerk it, you get this little wiggle in your swirls. So I don't want that either. But I don't like to spin it too fast as well, because some of the cells that come along the edge right here can start to shape like little pointed boomerangs. So once they start shaping like that, I tend to want to cut it off and say, no, 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 no more. This is enough. So you can spin it as many times as you like. You don't have to spin it so fast to try to get everything off at once. See how these swirls still have their shape without all that jiggling around. But actually, I really, really, really love this palette. So I think I'm going to be finished here. Let me get you down for a closer look. This one I'm very happy with. I see a lot of jelly beans in there and a lot of what I was trying to accomplish when I said of what's involved. So let me get a closer look. Okay, folks, I'm back. This is Sheldon again. Let me get the light from glaring on it. Yeah, I changed the light in my kitchen so you can see without the glare. Now you see the cell here. See, that's how it was layered. So you had the white pillow, which kind of made it glow the transparent Tuscan sun, which also made another glow through the magenta, which also it glowed through the dioxazine purple, and then the border, which was more opaque of the green gold, was there at, you know, around the cell activator. So you see that's how the cells shape here. And then some of them that didn't get some of the other colors got some of the Be Mine in there as well. But the whole point of the jelly bean is that you get those multicolor cells that kind of also have a glow in the middle to give it a 3D appearance. So that's it right there, is the whole piece. I'm gonna lift it up. And this is what I was talking about when I said spinning slowly. Now you have a slight bend on this part here, this line here, you have a slight bend. But in general, those swirls stayed intact. And I didn't waste a lot of paint because I didn't scrape the first painting, but rather I folded it in to save my pillow. So that was a nice little trick that I learned from Karen. Thanks a lot, Karen. You're the best. So again, this is Sheldon from Show Rock Art. And we always talk about jelly beans, and I wanna give a shout out to my fellow jelly beans in the acrylic pouring for beginners group. And that is, G from G Pores, Cy Frost from Frosty Eye Candy, Britta Clayton from Brick Plate Designs, Darren Nixon from Venom Fluid Art, and there are many others that's there to be able to share some of their experiences with you as well. So I'm going to sign off. And have a very great and wonderful day. Good night and happy pouring. Bye-bye.